knees down to the ground, because then we're in a winged position that's not really good for their feet. So we just put the feet in butterfly and lift the heels up off of the ground. We reach the heels and scoop underneath and pull them towards us. We begin with one foot at a time, lifting it towards our face. So we're not bringing the leg out to the side right away. Instead, we're bringing the leg towards our face so that we're pressing the knee away from the shoulder. Now they're experiencing this rotation of the hip. We bring it towards the face and set it down, and we use the other leg and bring this one towards our face, really pressing the knee away from the shoulder and setting it down. If they cannot lift the leg and press the knee away from the shoulder without letting go of their other foot, probably best to just hang out in this exercise before proceeding to the next section. The next section will be lifting and then opening to an attitude position and then bringing it back in and setting it down. So we're not going all the way out. We're rotating the leg first, then we're unfolding just enough, and you're going to find where their tightness and their IT band is. And then they're really, you're going to have to walk around and adjust their leg and let them feel what it feels like to rotate that leg and the hips out good. When they are at the point where they can balance and lift both legs up equally in this position, then we slowly begin to open the legs to the side. Depending on the child's flexibility, they may never get beyond this point. There's a lot of tension and tightness here behind the knees and in the IT band, and you have to stretch that out very carefully. And if you force the child to stretch their leg all the way straight, they're going to experience some snapping and popping here under the leg. So it's very important that you stress to them, we are not trying to get the legs straight, we are trying to get the legs rotated, and if you cannot straighten them all the way, that's fine. My legs never get straight in this position. Again, you do want to make sure that they're not leaning back, flexing the feet, switching the position, and that they are maintaining this position and holding the heels in the correct way. Now, if you do have a child who can extend the legs all the way up into the side, be sure that they do not lose their rotation in this position. It's very important that they understand that it's not about the height or the straightening of the leg, it's about the unfolding of the leg. Once they understand the unfolding, that's when I can start teaching developing properly. So at the bar, we go from row to row, we lift to attitude, to the front is obviously the easiest, and then we want to continue to unfold the leg to the side. And tendu close to the side. A lot of teachers will teach from row to row to bring the knee up into towards the armpit, keeping the thigh here and then extending the leg. I find that this causes the students to grip in the hip flexors, and although the hip flexors will technically engage during the developpe, it should not be initiated from the developpe, because then you end up with a lot of tension and the hip flexor will actually engage and push the leg down. It will stop the leg from allowing to have its full range of motion. So instead, what I like to do is, from the rotary position, I like to walk over and take the gear and unfold it this way, and then have them extend the leg to the side. Once they get that sort of opening towards the front feeling, then they're able to come through and have a better developpe with more rotation and more extension. So the last exercise that I do for helping my students get their extensions a little bit higher is actually a bar exercise. We start with the leg in alasegon at the bar, and it's not so much about getting the leg up as it is them experiencing the weightlessness of opposition. So what I usually have them do after doing a long bar stretch and really feeling the extent of their flexibility, we do a nice demi-plie and really feel the seat and the standing leg supporting, and then press down through the heel to stretch the leg all the way straight. So now they're really, really pressing down, they're pulling up in the abs, they're turning out here, and then we're gonna do again demi-plie, turn out this leg more, and as we press down, we're gonna press down very, very strongly through the heel of the standing leg, and we're going to rotate the heel up and off of the bar and set it back down again. Now it's important that they don't grip in the quads, and again, it's not about the height. I'm not asking them to lift their leg off of the bar. I am simply asking them to feel how much they can press down and rotate at the same time. The student may not be able to lift their leg off the bar at all. They're still going to get a lot out of this exercise. So again, demi-plie, and as they straighten, rotate the leg in the hip socket. And they're going to feel like the leg is just sort of suspended up in the hip. And that weightlessness is going to allow them to have a lot more rotation when they get into the center, when they're doing any sort of developpe or bon mot, They're going to really tap into the heel of the standing leg as their support system, and their extensions are going to be significantly better. Special thanks to Apollo Shocks for sending me amazing shoe socks. That's why they're called shocks, as they're shoes and socks at the same time. I love these. I'm just getting used to them. At first, they were kind of difficult to figure out how to use, but I'm really loving them now. Lots of arch support. I also had a great pair of shorts sent to me by another great company, and so I'll put the link in the description for this video. Thanks again, guys.